Hi everyone, and welcome to this review note. In this clip, we're going to be configuring the WSUS role on our Windows server so that we can apply patches out onto our network. Going to install the role, and I normally wouldn't do this in a video clip, but there's a few things that we need to look at here. Let's go through the normal process to start. The role we're going to install is the one on the very bottom, which is WSUS itself. Notice when I choose that and say add the features that it installs WSUS and it also installs Internet Information Server because WSUS is a web-based application. Let's go next. I'm not going to install any extra options. I'm going to install the internal database. This is going to install SQL Express and also the service itself. If I was going to attach to a separate database, then I would eliminate this guy and connect onto this one, or select this one instead. Say next. Now, the other thing we have to do right now is specify the path where the information is going to be stored for updates. I've created an updates folder on the E drive, so I'm just going to specify that path. And I'm good to go with that. Go through next. I'm not going to modify the role services for Internet Information Server. Next and install. It's going to take a few minutes. I'll pause the video and we'll come back when this is finished. Okay, the role is now installed. I'm going to close this. We have to do some post-installation setup. Notice that there's a notification badge and there's an option here to launch the post-installation tasks. Found from practical experience that works with varying degrees of success. Instead, I'm going to launch the new WSUS utility that has been installed as part of the role. And that will come up. It wants to confirm we're going to use updates as the path, which is fine. And then it's going to go through and actually set up the database. Okay, so that's finished up. We can see the message that we've successfully completed post-installation. I'll close this. And once I've done that, it's going to launch the setup wizard for WSUS. You see the utility starting now. So a few things that we have to set up here. It's mentioning that if we have to open firewall ports and that, we need to do that, which is fine. Going to go through and wants to know if I want to be part of the Microsoft Improvement Program. Because this is a demo, I'll disable that. And where are we going to synchronize from? So I'm going to go out and synchronize from Microsoft's main update servers on the internet. I'm not using a proxy server, so I don't have to configure that. And before we can actually start specifying the rest of the information, we have to connect out onto Microsoft's update services and find out what's actually available to us. So I'll start connecting. This can take several minutes. Pause the video and we'll come back when that's done. Okay, so this is now finished up and going to click next. Have to specify our language or languages, our case English only. And we also get to pick the products that we want to include. Now, most of them are not selected by default. You can take a look down through this list and you'll see all kinds of things that go way back in time. I'm going to come down to Office and deselect that because I don't want it. I'm also going to come down to Windows and deselect that because I do not want to go all the way back to Windows XP. And I'm just going to come down until I find Server 2012. I'm going to pick drivers and I'm going to pick Server 2012 R2 itself. Click on next. I'll take security definition updates and security updates. I'm not going to take anything else. Now, very often you would, but I'm going to pass on those because I don't want it to take forever to actually try and find out what updates there are available. Click on next. I'm going to do a manual synchronization. In production, you would have this set that you would automatically look every day to find out what updates or patches are available. And I'm going to tell it I want to begin the initial synchronization and then finish. That's going to go off and do its thing. It's connecting out to Microsoft's update servers, and it's going to go off and actually synchronize to find out what updates are available. And that's it for the initial installation. That's a wrap for this video. Hopefully this has been helpful for you, and we'll see you next time.